Are we ready?
Check.
Are we ready?
Got my shade?
We ready?
I mean, I guess.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I ain't saying we live today, you know what I'm saying? It's a lot going on now, so I just want to make sure we ready.
Yeah.
You know, you ready, Shay? What's up? Like, what's going on? Why are you looking like you?
This has been an emotional week for me.
I know.
It's just been, it's a lot, it's been going long. On. Yeah, it's been very emotional.
Yeah,
but
yeah, yeah.
I'm ready.
Well, we back. Italkgrey. Got my dog. Figgy.
DJ Shimmy.
You know what I'm saying? The goddess Shayna in the building.
Blessings, 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 peoples.
You know what I'm saying? It's going to be all right, goddess.
I hope so, you know what I'm saying? I'm not like, protected out here. So, you know, it's like, you know, I haven't had a hug lately. So, you know.
Really? You got to hug a tree.
I will. As soon as we leave from here, you know, I'll make sure I jump on that.
Sometimes you got to hug yourself in the mirror.
I have as well. But, you know.
Yeah.
But it's confusing. It's emotional for you, but confusing for me. So.
Really? Why?
Me too.
Tired of Karen? Karen and Karen.
Karen, Michaels, Jacobs, all of them. I'm tired of all of them. Confused on what's going on, conspiracies.
Yeah. I don't like the word conspiracy. I feel like the conspiracy theorist was created to take away from people that think. You know what I'm saying? Like, some of this shit be real. Like, WP, white power, is real. Or white privilege, shall I say.
Of course.
You see what I'm saying?
Of course.
Like that lady who called the cops. But you saw how she switched up?
Yeah. Instant. Like,
instant yeah. Quaker Oats. Like, like she did it like, oh my God, you know a black man is about to kill me.
You can tell that wasn't her first time. That's why. That's she been up. Doing that.
She saw the video. She saw videos on the internet and she tried to use it against herself.
You know what I'm saying? Like, use it to her advantage.
Yeah.
Like, come on, yo. They always do that. Like, this new spot I just moved in. Like, why y'all running around with y'all dogs off the leash, B? Like,
so you can say something.
Let it bite you so you can sue the fair thing you got.
I ain't trying. I don't know. I'm about to kick that in the head.
Let it bite you. Sue the fair thing you got. Sue them.
I don't know if I can take a bite from a Doberman pincher.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? But they
That's
relate
rabies
to that
101.
Shit. Hell yeah. They always with their dogs, like, even in the restaurant. Like, yo, we up in the restaurant. I'm trying to get my, you know what I'm saying, lo mein.
I never really understood when you let the dog, like, lick him.
Lick him in the...
Can eat off the spoons and all wild crazy shit.
That's not happening.
Like, come on. Like, how far are we really going to go with it? You know what I'm saying?
It's hard. They care about animals more than people.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah. You saw what happened to Mike Vick.
Yeah.
Let's be clear.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's be clear.
He spent more jail time than people.
Hell yeah. All he was doing was dog fighting. But when you go into the gun stores... Or the gun actual shops, they got heads of like deers
and stuff sitting like
all types of stuff. Yeah. So y'all killing like they over there chilling.
Since when they was young, they got their kids even out there killing, hunting, and all of that. But that's normal for them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But we fight dogs, you know, with killers.
Exactly. But I do feel like that's something that we do have to start getting comfortable with, and that's learning how to use a weapon. You see what I'm saying? Like a lot of times when I go to the gun range, I see a lot of them there. You know what I'm saying? You know, Caucasians, shall I say. You know what I mean? Like, they're there. And, you know, we too busy down in iguanas. You know what I'm saying? Like, we have to start getting back into that mindset. You know what I mean? Like, of how to use a weapon. All this, oh, no justice, no peace, and protesting. I mean, I get it. You know, if you're not really educated on a certain level and realize that a lot of these things have already been occurring since Martin Luther King.
Correct.
You know what I mean? Trayvon Martin, you know what I mean? All of these things has already been happening. Like, we've been doing all this stuff already. Yeah. We've been protesting. We've been marching. So I understand, like, if you're not really abreast of this type of information and you're just getting emotional, that's what you're going to feel like you can do. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. But no, we have to understand that we can't just get into this situation right here. We got to go back and start reading. You know what I'm saying? Stop being afraid to pick up a book, brothers and sisters. You know what I'm saying?
Like, it's more like social media nowadays. Like, they're more on social media. Whatever social media posts, that's what they learn from social media.
Yeah. No.
Right, because it's convenient. So a lot of people just can see what's happening now. They're not going to have the time or the luxury to even go back because
the
technology is right in your hand now.
Yeah, the convenience.
So come on,
yeah,
who's going to go try to go download that book? Yeah, when you can just go type in the hashtag.
It's so crazy. Like,
you're not gonna do that.
You be on Twitter
right
and somebody post something about what's going on right now.
Yeah.
And they'll automatically believe it. No, somebody can already be bullshitting, you know?
Yeah. Correct. Instead of go do their own research. Yeah. Because there's a lot of information. Like, that post might have one bit
a factual
information.
Correct.
But then you got to go read the rest of the book, or you got to go listen to the rest of the lecture to get the full in-depth scope of what's really going on. Correct. You see what I'm saying? Because they've been killing us, even with Rodney King.
Correct.
This ain't nothing new. You know what I'm saying? So we have to start understanding that we have to change our mindset. I ain't trying to hear no more dumbed down 1D, you know, I'm slinging my rocks. I don't hear none of that type music no more. All that's dead. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, we have to raise our vibrations. You know what I mean? And understand that we got to get away from all this stuff that's been killing us in the first place.
All these distractions.
Yes, yeah. All the distractions. Because you notice, look at, since all this COVID stuff has been going down.
Yeah, ain't no more football, no more basketball. Yeah. So that's why you see more people out here rioting, because yeah. It's really convenient. That's how I've been looking at the riots.
And they probably just want to come outside anyway.
You know, correct. Yeah, everybody been on lockdown, so yeah, why not true. Go protest?
Yeah.
But it's funny how it really takes this death in 2020 for everybody from every state to finally start protesting together.
All across the world. Like, they was protesting over there, like in Berlin.
And China, too.
And yeah. Yeah.
I'm just like, damn, even though I thought Chinese people don't like black people, they just,
I felt like that too. You know
what
I'm saying?
That's why it just feels like something fishy with all of that. Like, think about it. Come on. Like, when you just think about it. So everywhere, like nationwide, is on a black power movement. Come on.
Why all of a sudden?
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I guess they feel like they finally realized that, you know, black is the dominant race.
We were the first race.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. What happened to that all lives matter type talk? Nah. Now we all black lives matters, you know what I'm saying? But we ain't gonna front like we don't know George Soros is behind that movement. Correct. You know what I'm saying? Like, just, we know.
Correct. And even just the word black, like, we shouldn't even really jump on that, because once you learn what the word black means, like, in a legal standpoint, you lose your rights by even saying black.
Real?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Correct. So that black on black movement, that was just fun. I think it just became relevant in 2013 or 2012.
Oh, snap. Yes.
That just was formed from, like, I think it was the Trayvon Martin case.
Yeah, it was Trayvon Martin.
So it's like,
enlighten us, goddess. You know what I'm saying?
It's like, we got to read, as we said. You know, right. We have to. Like, people just jumping on Black Lives Matters when you got to really do your research. Before we was called black, we was called Negroes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
that was one of the terms. Yeah.
Why all of a sudden did they stop saying that?
Before that was niggers.
You feel me?
So. Negos.
Colors.
Yeah.
But now we're black.
Yeah.
And then you think about it, you don't see any Caucasian Americans. You see African Americans. Like, how's that?
Color people. So like, it makes no sense.
All those are distractions of words. Yes.
Yeah. It has to be a label that's given to us. You know what I'm saying?
When you really think about it, that's kind of fucked up, too.
What?
Caucasians for white people, black people. African, like, it doesn't make sense. Like,
it's an African American, but we're not even in Africa right now. We're in America.
Well, we're Africans living in America. You know what I'm saying? We ain't land on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock landing on us.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, white people.
What do you mean, so they say?
I mean, who knows where we really was from? I mean, that's a different topic. I'm not going to bring that up now. Who really knows who is the black people over here?
Like, I feel like black people was everywhere.
That's what I'm trying to say.
We originated. No, we could jump into that because we got to go back a little bit. Today, we're going to go back a little bit. You know what I'm saying? We understand that. We as African people, we did originate from Africa. You see what I'm saying? Yes, we spread out. So when the Europeans came over here, there were Africans here already.
Correct.
And in South America, you could go back and look at the Olmec heads.
Correct.
10-ton stone heads that's carved, nose big, like, you see what I'm saying? So you know that was us with the braids. Correct. We were in Australia, the in Tasmania. That's where they look at the stuff that they put in the movies. That's where they were depicting the Tasmanian devil.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? But they went over there as well too. We were in China. We were in Europe. So we were everywhere.
I was told because when you were thinking about it, you see the Philippines, they're not fully like majority of them are not fully like white or like a white color. They got a darkness in them.
But we mixed in, you know what I'm saying?
So we was everywhere.
Black people
are everywhere. It's just not one place.
That's why we got to learn our history. You know what I'm saying? We have to, you know. I'm not really, normally, you know, back in the day, I used to bang on people that was following a certain religious belief.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to do that now. You see what I'm saying? Regardless of whatever you believe, that's fine. If you think, you know, JC coming back and saving you, you think Allah, that's cool. We could debate that after.
Correct.
As long as you are black. You have to understand we have the same fight. You see what I'm saying? And now we got to come together and start sitting down and figuring out how we're going to get out of this mess. You know what I'm saying?
As long as you are with color. Yes, let's not say black. As long as we're with color.
Okay, okay. I thought you were going to say like white people. Because they got some white people that are with us too.
Yeah, but what about the people? That is true. That is true.
Jada don't want to hear that. You got people like Jane Elliott. Mm-hmm. She is a teacher.
She's a real one.
You see what I'm saying? She speaks against white supremacy all the time.
One time for Jane.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You got people like Tim Wise. Mm-hmm. He's another one that speaks about the injustices of white people and the white benefits that they have. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's a, you know, poquito. You know what I'm saying? It's a few of them.
Small percentage.
Yeah. You know what I mean? That's better
than nothing, to be honest with you. When you think about it.
You know what I mean? But we see those that are out there spraying, because you know, you notice they got some of them out there all masked up spraying Black Lives Matter on walls and shit.
They just
like
want to vandalize.
Yeah, like, no. Well, I feel like they were put there to antagonize the situation.
Yeah,
that's exactly why we don't need to be out there.
Correct. Because they want to make it look like it's us, but it's actually other people that's doing the crimes that's out there in the riots.
It's like, not no offense, but it's a lot of them skater people. Who's really doing the damages?
Skater people?
Yeah, it's the skateboard peoples.
Rock stars?
Whatever they call them. No offense to them. But I just seen too many videos on social media. They using a skateboard to break windows and stuff like that. I done saw a video the other day. There's one using a skateboard to break a window for no apparent reason. Mm-hmm. And the black guy just took the skateboard out of his hand. And he's like, what you doing? And he just walked away.
Citizens arrest.
Yeah.
He was paid to do that.
Exactly.
Probably.
Paid agents.
That's what they do, yes.
That's why we got to get from out there, man. We can't be out there. What they're trying to do is just antagonize the situation, get us all in our feelings, get us all riled up, so we just ready to, yo, I'm ready to kill anything.
Correct.
No, we got to start using logics. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Not more so emotion, because emotions will get you killed. And I tell you that all the time. Like back in the day when I was in New York, you know, 718.
Here we go.
You know, I was kind of bad a little bit. Uh-huh. And you saw those kids. You know, it's like 10 of us. And that one kid, you could tell he watched a Street Fighter. He would go, nigga, that ain't gonna work. You know, hey, you get your ass stomped out anyway. You know what I mean? But that's him being in his emotions. Yeah. And we can't get into that. We can't run out here trying to hold a gun sideways. Like, nah, that's not gonna work when these motherfuckers is trained. They know how to, you see what I'm saying? Yeah. We got to start getting into that too. Yeah. When I went to that boxing gym downtown Broward, it was nothing but them in there. And I'm talking about from little kids in there. Like, learning
like
to punching trees and shit.
Yeah, learning to defend themselves.
Yeah. But we over here want to teach our daughters about a hot girl summer. Like, I don't want to hear none of that. Sorry, Megan. You know what I'm saying? We ain't trying to. Sorry. This right is now. The reason why you got motherfuckers like Trina.
Let's not even get on Trina. You know, like, come on. Like, what a, cool. Like, come on. Like, you have the power. Like, you have your platform. Cool. Like, why would you think that was okay to say all those things?
Like Trick Daddy said. Like Trick Daddy said, she takes everything personal.
Yes.
Personal. You cannot. In situations like this, you can have personal situations.
You live on the air. Like, how do you think that was?
Calling us animals.
I think she had to make a sacrifice for that. You know, I'm always on some conspiracy stuff. So. You know, like, I just felt like
she got paid for that.
Of course. Like,
no, like she said, she said her friend who shot was in Bayside got, you know, ransacked, destroyed and all that stuff. That's why.
If she would have kept continuing talking about her brother that got killed, I think that it would have been more of like, we could understand, but you're talking about somebody's shop that got insurance. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Do you even own the shop or you just renting it?
Thank you.
Like, let's be clear.
It's insurance anyways. Like, she's talking about, she got a kid and she don't got as much money as me. Okay, why don't you give her money then?
Thank you. Exactly. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, all that was.
Stop trying to put sorrow.
Trina just reminds me of a lot of our brothers and sisters that are still out here. That's uneducated. You know what I'm saying? And
right,
I feel like she tied that in with her emotions. Like, I don't feel like we should cancel her. Like, I feel like we so quick to cancel
our brothers.
She shouldn't
get canceled, but she just shouldn't have spoke on that. Like, you can't speak on something that you're not familiar with.
Yeah.
You
know well, to them, like, they might feel like they're inclined to do it. You know what I mean?
Because they're a celebrity?
Yeah.
Even look, but think about it. Like, Trick Daddy was going out. He's like, yo, why are you taking
this? He was trying to save her.
And she said, like, yo, your shop, what if they did that to your Sunday's eatery?
She started saying, collard greens.
Yo, you got to understand. Like,
ribs. Like, you heard what she kept saying afterwards. Like, that was wild, just like, too much.
He just can't be going
wild
like that. Like,
yes.
That's just nonsense. Like,
yeah.
Come on, like.
Well, I'm not in the business of trying to lead a horse to water. You know what I'm saying? You can't make them drink. You know, if they're willing to learn, I'm okay with that. Because I used to debate. I used to debate mom all
you
the
time. You still are, do you still do?
I don't really, no. I don't do it anymore. It's too much energy. Oh, okay. That's why I switched over to interacting with children. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I got to argue with you, if I got to argue with you, why you need to get your credit score to 800, I ain't got time for that. I ain't putting my energy on that. So with adults, if you want to learn, if you want to learn the history and understand that, you know, the Arabians were the first ones to enslave us before the Caucasian. You see what I'm saying? Where was that mob saving us then?
Who? Nope.
JC, or whoever you want to believe in. Nobody wasn't saving us. If you go back to the Haitian Revolution, you know what I mean?
We had to save ourselves.
We had to save ourselves.
I love it.
Yeah.
Even in Jamaica with the Maroons, even over here in America, you know what I'm saying? We had to save ourselves with the Gullah Wars. We had to save ourselves.
Correct.
So we can't be sitting down here talking about, let me pray. No, you got to get ready to spray.
Yeah.
Man, you could pray first.
Pray before you get into battle. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
Yeah.
Because you gotta,
our ancestors could still hear us when we're praying. So we just got to be praying with the right intentions.
They give you the strength and the power.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's why we got to get back to that. We got to get back to that spirituality. Like, and they know this too. Like, y'all seen Black Panther, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Everybody's seen that. Remember when they put him in the dirt?
Yeah.
To go see his pops.
Correct.
That's real shit. Mm-hmm. So whoever made that movie, you know that they understood.
They know something.
They know about African spirituality. You see what I'm saying? Because that wasn't just that was astral projection.
Correct.
So if we understand that we have the ability to do that now, then we could be stronger as a people, because that's one of the things that separate us from them.
Correct. You know what I
mean? Being a little bit more in tune.
Like, I don't think they're really spiritual like us. Like, you know.
They're not. They don't have a soul. Let's be clear. You know, they technically don't really have a soul. So, like, that's why, like.
About 80% maybe, I would say.
Okay, we'll give them 80. But, you know, that's why when we start saying things like spirituality and we start saying things like, you know, we're connecting with, you know, the people that have died, they start looking at us confused. Yes, yeah, they start looking at us confused, and they start saying that we're worshiping something that they can't relate to because they're not supposed to.
Yeah,
like, they try to demonize it.
Yes.
Like for example, voodoo, with the Haitian voodoo. People
they
think it's like devil worship, and no, it's nothing like that. That's really a religion, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
what helped, like, back the Haitians back in the days, gave them the strength and stuff like that to beat the, you know, the French. Yeah. Like, so.
Yeah, yeah. They beat their colonizers.
Yes. Let's put it like colonizer. That. Let's put it like that.
Yeah.
That's why a lot of people don't like Haitians, because, you know.
Yeah. Well, I ain't on front. Back in New York, Haitians had it bad.
Yeah, they don't like Haitians.
Even growing up, nobody didn't really want to claim it.
Yeah.
Like,
I didn't even know there was light-skinned Haitians.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything.
For real.
I feel like out of the black people, they like the Haitians the worst, because you were the first person to get independence and all that
stuff.
Yes.
1804, shall I say? Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
January 1st, 1804.
Yeah. No. I feel you. They got it the worst back in my high school. Like, I remember this one dude, we was in the pizza shop, and he was like, man, I ain't Haitian, I'm French. And then one of his homeboys was like, like, I guess cussing him out. In Creole, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, you better stop saying that. You better stand up, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And stop playing around. But, you know, you made a valid point there. That's why they bang on Haiti so much.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's like a representation of what we can do.
Right.
So they have to make sure they destroy that. Even to this day, they still do those things. A lot of people don't realize a lot of these natural disasters, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I might say it's conspiracy, but these shits is set up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The harp.
Yeah.
Where, like a weather modifier.
Yeah.
Where they can manipulate the weather.
You can see that shit to Haiti.
Yeah, that's why we get that earthquake, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We the poorest country on the Western Hemisphere, but we got our independence first. Like, exactly. They know what we can do. They know what we about. They know what we can do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Everything is controlled, man. They're like 10 steps ahead of us, man. Like, honestly. Exactly.
That's why we got a thing. But I know we're smarter than
them. They steadied us.
Like, oh yeah,
we're smarter than them.
We're smarter and stronger than them.
We
just got to unite and be, you know,
get organized.
Yeah,
like the way that we was built, our structure, they knew we was gonna overpower them. So that's why now what they do is they try to mentally enslave us.
Correct.
So like all these things that we're saying now, that's the worst thing to do to anybody. Just like, you know, like the Matrix. Yeah. You know, I finally got a chance to watch it. You know.
You watch Neo?
Yeah, I just, you know, I just was able to watch it. You see how, like, they had to get in his mind. So every time he came out of it, he didn't know which life was real, which one wasn't. It's like, yeah. Right now, like.
Wait, what Matrix y'all talking about?
The first one.
The first one.
You talking about the Matrix when he did a thing to the white people and chasing him? You know,
the
that's.
Agents.
You know, that's.
That's where we at right now.
No, you know, I did some research. You know, that's really not a movie. He said that's really like a documentary.
Yeah, it was a black woman that wrote that.
Yeah, you know it's saying? Really a documentary. Correct. It's really not like a movie. I told somebody that. It was just like, what you mean? Matter of fact, I posted on Snapchat. I was like, what the hell are you talking about? It's a movie. I said, all right, it's a documentary. All right.
No, yo, there's always truth in a movie. You know what I'm saying? It's just that a lot of us, we just looking for some form of entertainment. You know what I'm saying? And we got to realize that we got to get away from that. You know what I mean? Because how long are we going to keep playing in the circus? But even if you looked at like Avatar.
Good movie.
Notice when they were fighting all the machines and things like that, what did they do? You know what I mean? He had to go talk to Atawa, you know what I mean? To the tree, you know?
So basically, Avatar is basically like the African.
Fighting their colonizers. Exactly.
I never thought about it like that. And I love that movie too. That's the funny thing about it, bro. I love that movie.
Avatar was great. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of people, it went over a lot of people's heads. You know what I'm saying? They just looked at it.
About that today.
For real. Facts. They just thought it was a normal movie. Nah. And you noticed. That's why I try to tell people all the time. You know what I mean? We are human beings having, we are spiritual beings having a human experience. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? We ain't just pop up here. We came from somewhere here.
Correct.
You know? So we have to get in tune with our inner spirit. Right. You know what I mean? Because you notice, like, if you look at the movie, he was the military cat, and his legs was broken. But then when he got into the Avatar body,
he became
you know what I'm saying?
That makes so much sense.
Exactly. It's the same thing with us. What happened, goddess?
I mean, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I haven't watched Avatar yet.
You ain't seen Avatar?
So I'm going to put it on the movie list.
What's going on?
I was just in my own bubble, you know, protecting my kids, you know.
You wasn't no hot girl summer? You wasn't twerking?
Are you quarantined?
We're not quarantined no more, Shimmy.
Yeah,
I mean, I wasn't doing it in the first place, but I'm just saying.
I can't believe you ain't seen Avatar.
That's a great movie.
That movie was dope.
I know. I'm going to make sure I watch it. I'm going to go watch it again.
Just because get that spiritual message.
That was the first one I was telling you to watch to see if you was able to gonna connect the dots.
I thought you said The Matrix first.
No, I said Avatar.
Oh, well.
Because Matrix is a little bit older. You know what I'm saying?
To be honest with you. This one ain't got that blue Blu-ray. It's clear. It's,
yeah. Yeah, man. Like the visuals on that was dope.
That, you know what I'm saying? I'm a disbelief.
You in disbelief? You shocked? Yeah. A lot of us gonna be shocked because it's hard. I'm not gonna front. It is hard, especially if you grew up a certain type of way and you were taught that this was the way to be. Yeah. So now when you come into a shock, you know what I mean? Like, you don't know what to do because we so want to get used to the lifestyle that we have. You know,
right.
We all want to order wings. You know what I'm saying? Five guys and shit. I ain't gonna front. It's good. But we got to get away from that because that's another thing that's killing us. Our diet. A lot of us don't realize that. You know, we all ready to get back to the club. Like, I was watching this video online and this black guy was doing the crump in front of the cops. Like,
yeah,
look, everybody was like, oh, yeah, see what I'm saying? We need that. No, you looking like a clown, man.
That shit like the stupidest hell.
Yeah, like they not playing. They militant. We ain't got time to be. Nobody don't want to see none of that shit.
But nothing didn't happen to him, right?
Nah.
But he just looked stupid doing it.
Yeah. And I get it. You know what I'm saying? He probably just frustrated. He don't know what to do because
started crunking?
Yeah, he started.
Probably using his dancing to release himself.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Go hug a tree, brother. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of energy.
It been really fucked up when he was doing that and they beat him. The cops beat him.
That's what I'm saying.
It been really fucked up.
It's like, I get it. You know, a lot of us don't understand the history. We don't understand what's going on. We're just trying to release some form of energy. I do see a lot of people talking about, like, man, yo, like, how y'all can stand there? You know, why y'all ain't do something? Like, let's be for real.
You mean, like, the person that recorded the whole George Floyd thing?
I feel like that's
that
all
she should have just
She's a really, woman. Yeah, who's
that's,
really going to...
That's all they really could have
done. Yeah, and there was guys there, too, but who's really going to put their hand on a cop?
Because that automatically, boom, dead.
You dead. One. Yeah. You getting locked up.
Yeah.
Who gonna bail you out? You know what I'm saying?
Who's to say that he wasn't gonna just shoot her right then and there? Like, yeah. Come on, man. I feel you think he's just gonna let her attack her for no reason?
Like, to be honest with you, I might seem wrong by saying this, but the only time I feel like you, other than recording, putting your hands on a cop, is like during a protest when the cop's like pushing people and shooting people. Mm-hmm. I feel like the only acceptable time to help to help the person out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But like at that time, you can't really do nothing. Now, I just saw a video. A cop done put somebody's mother, a white lady, in a head, like a headlock.
For real?
Yeah.
I saw that they banned headlocks in some, I forgot what state it was. They said that they can't do the chokeholds no more.
Shit. Yeah. I remember that vividly.
Yeah, they actually just banned it.
That's fucked up.
For real?
Yeah, recently.
Yeah.
I forgot what state, but yeah.
Because it's like, come on, you got to put me in a suplex to
take me down. Like, they don't put you, they don't slam you, you don't lost your breath, you're in just shock. Get on your stomach and put your hands out. Like, bro, I can't believe what's going on right now.
I'm not resisting, officer.
You already didn't.
You got all your weight on me and shit. Like,
hell yeah.
I know, man. I feel like now, not everybody really going against the cops. Now they're realizing how much authority the cops have. You know what I mean? Not other than it being Black Lives Matter. Now they're seeing police brutality and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Now, like, I feel like that's why a lot of white people, Caucasians, or people of different color, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
They're really coming together with the Black Lives Matter
to,
like, you know, go against that police brutality.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I feel like there's a division between the police officers and the whole police department. You know what I'm saying? Like, they do have some good cops, but then there's a lot of them on there that's secretly on some KKK shit. Because I remember watching a video with the KKK and one of the Grand Masters, and he was saying, well, you know, now we're taking off the sheets. We're your governors. We're your police officers. We're your doctors.
They're the new KKK, the police officer. They're not wearing that white robe no more. They're wearing blue.
They done took off the sheets.
Yeah, they're wearing the blue and black.
Exactly. Correct. You know what I'm saying?
That's how they all get you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, we got to understand the history of the police department within itself. Like, it started as the slave patrol.
Correct.
To catch slaves. You see what I'm saying? Back in slavery. And then it just grew into what it is now. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
In the, I believe it was like 1915, they incorporated the fraternal order of police. So in each state, there's like a captain or a headmaster that's in that actual fraternal. So those are the new like hit people for the KKK, basically.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. No. Yeah, you're right. That's what I'm saying. That's the division. Mm-hmm. They do have those type of police. Those ones that have that KKK mentality.
Correct.
And then you have the good cops. You know what I'm saying? So as a good cop, like, let's say you're a good cop, how can you really speak out? Because
You're going to pick blue before you pick somebody else, a human's life. You're going to pick your
gang.
Yes.
Gang.
Correct. And that's going to be that uniform that you wear with.
The cop's the biggest game in the world, man.
Hell yeah.
Correct.
Biggest game. You're talking about this other stuff. And the cop's the biggest game, man.
Right. So you can't really say good or bad, because once you got that uniform on, you kind of no major choice at that time.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like the ones who are good, they were
getting overshadowed. It's gonna get overshadowed, because of all the other
let me verify. Did you see the movie with Frank Lucas?
Which one? American Gangster?
American Gangster. Did you see that?
You kind of just put me on movie blast today. I've been in my own bubble for a long time.
What's up, bro?
I'm going to be honest with you guys. Like,
you don't watch movies?
No, it was like they got me on like all the distraction movies. Like all the like.
What? Too Wong Fu?
Yeah, like the Djangos, the 12 Years of Slaves. I watched all of them.
You watched the emotion reactive movies.
Yes, they got to my head. That's why I keep telling you, we got to change our mental state. Because, they got me to like the Harriet Tubmans. I watched all of them. And I missed out on all of the real movies that I was supposed to be watching.
Okay. It's okay.
It's all right. You're going to binge watch.
You were distracted.
I was. They distracted me real good. Yeah, they did.
I don't know. I'm younger than you, and I saw them in the movies.
In American Gangster, there was the cop that took down Frank Lucas. They found $1 million in the trunk. You see what I'm saying? And the officer was like, yo, let's keep it. I would have kept that shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, I find $1 million unmarked bills, it don't whip.
Because what else are they going to do with it?
He turned it in. he was in the station turning it in.
And what did they do with the turned in money?
probably kept it, put it in their pocket.
To them, yes.
You know what I'm saying? But what they that did was black mark them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to say black mark. Sorry. That
they marked
black,
it.
Yeah, they marked them. Yes. Mm-hmm. Let's remove the black.
It's all right.
Yes.
So they was in a situation where his friend was at a crack house or whatever the case may be in the hood, and they were trying to call backup, and nobody would come help them. You know what I'm saying?
The money in.
Yeah. There was a lot of cops under the tank.
That's what I'm saying. So yeah. He didn't pick blue that time. He picked his human. He like ordered and writes. Yeah, and look what happened.
Yeah. He was by the books 100%. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I feel like there are some cops are like that, but they can't. How much cops can really speak out and say,
correct.
Yo, because I've seen this, I've seen that. They might get their head knocked off.
Correct. And sometimes they might lose their lives. So whose life is really going to be at stake?
Sometimes I feel like, you done?
Oh, go ahead.
You sure?
Yeah.
I'm not a rude person or anything like that.
Go ahead, Shemmy.
Because sometimes, like, you know, the cops who really like really wanted to be cops and like make a change, they come in brand new and they got a partner who been here and is like, man, let's arrest that motherfucker, man. Like, you know, they planting stuff on people and stuff like that. Yeah. So don't get me wrong, there's some good cops. I don't count for some good cops, you know.
You know, that believe in the system.
Yeah.
A lot of people believe in this system.
Correct.
You see what I'm saying? We even got them at our jobs. You know, you got mums in there that they like the 9-to-5 is the new plantation.
Facts.
Like, let's just keep this clear. That's you know what I'm saying? You got mums there that you could tell who would have been
a
who
worker
if it was slavery time. Like, you could tell who the house nigga was and you could tell who the field niggas was.
Correct.
You see what I'm saying? Like, I remember I was in a situation where I was getting transferred from another department. You know what I'm saying? And another dude came in and was like, yeah, man, you ain't back there no more. Get your ass. And I'm like, I don't give a damn. Like, this is a job for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is this ain't where I'm gonna end up. But he was so proud to say that. Like, you got the motherfuckers that go above and beyond.
That's what I said.
Yeah.
And they
once they get you
the
mentally,
same amount as you, man.
Yes.
The fuck out of here, man. Like,
Jimmy,
to be honest,
Jimmy
with
hot.
No, because it's true. Because like my jobs, I'm all about my respect. You're not just gonna come in disrespecting me. I don't care who you think you is. Or what you think you like. No. I'm not dealing with a lot of that stuff. You know what I mean? Even my job right now. But, you know, but stuff happens. But
You can see the mentality of the people that's there at the job. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. When they go out their way, and it's always the black ones, where they do more than what is actually necessary. You know what I'm saying? To show, like, look, I'm impartial, master. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to take this nigga down. Like, yo, this ain't your money. This ain't your business.
Yeah.
Why you going so hard? Like, yo, let a nigga slide. You know what I'm saying? Like,
see,
what the fuck?
People like that, you know, like the Haitian Revolution, before they started, took out all the snitches. That's the first person you're going for.
You're right. A lot of the mulattoes. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I got love for my light-skinned people. Don't get me wrong. You know what I'm saying?
Do
Shana,
you?
Of course. Like, there were light-skinned people in Africa that didn't have no mixed with any type of Caucasian ancestry. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't really understand that. The sand people. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But a lot of people don't realize the mulattoes were used strategically to dismantle rebellions. You see what I'm saying? Because when you got to realize your mama's white, your dad's black. Or let's say your dad's white, because most likely that's where we would have been the master. So your dad is white and your mom is black. So genetically now, you have that empathy and sympathy for your master. You see what I'm saying? Because it's in you.
Correct.
You know what I mean? So me and Shimmy ready to burn shit down. We're like, yo, Shayna, what's up? You riding with us? Whose side you on, bruh?
Yes, Shayna.
We all know.
Are you helping us burn down this shit?
Let's be clear, I'm going to be on my melanin side. Always.
Okay, okay, okay.
You know what's so crazy? I know for a fact, like, George Washington, Benjamin Franklin, they have kids. They had kids with black women.
Oh, yeah.
So do they really get that same treatment? Like, because, you know, that's...
They get a little better... They get a little better treatment. I was about to say Bella, because there was a movie called Bella.
Mm-hmm.
A black girl. Well, she was interracial. A mulatto. Mm-hmm. And her dad was a master, and her mom was a regular slave. But she got good treatment. Like, she... When he died...
Yeah,
like, she was in the palace and certain stuff like that. I mean, even though she couldn't come out when guests would come over, but she had, like, crazy bread. So they did... Some of them did get the better treatment. You know what I'm saying? But that's why you see it here still today. We got to understand that things were embedded in our DNA.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? To the point where this is the reason why we still dislike each other. You see what I'm saying? Or why a light-skinned person would feel like they better than me or whatever the case may be. Because it's been going back from since slavery.
Yeah.
I forgot her name. Joy DeGry speaks about that. Like the psychological effects of slavery, like postpartum syndrome. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's like something that's called adaptive behavioral patterns.
Right.
So like, let's say your child, you know what I'm saying? Like Shayna, you know? Oh no, I don't want to use you as an example.
No, you
I don't want to push that energy on you. You know what I'm saying?
No, no bad vibes around
yeah.
here.
Let's say a mom is going to parents' teachers' night, right? Mm-hmm. And there's a white parent there, you know, and she's there. And the white parent is like, oh, wow, you know, your child is doing great in school. Oh, him? Oh, that headache? Yeah, I mean, he aight. That's a pattern that has been passed down from slavery. Because back on the plantation, the master would come and say, you know, Jimmy mm-hmm. doing pretty good out here. You know, he's picking a lot. Oh, no, Jimmy's a bum. He's no good.
Because she probably wanted to protect him.
Correct.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that behavior is still now within us now. You see a lot of parents, they, oh, my little pain in the butt. Why, like, a tear down has to be considered a compliment. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of us don't realize that. Like, that's the slave mentality that has been seeped into our DNA that we have to start coming to a realization of what happened to us. We didn't get no therapy after they freed us, supposedly freed us. You know what I'm saying? Because they didn't really free us, but supposedly we didn't get no therapy. We didn't sit down in no chair.
They didn't teach us how to go into the real world afterwards.
Exactly.
Yeah, they just told us to...
be free.
Yeah.
They wasn't free for it. This is giving them a bigger space to run.
Yeah. Wow. Well, we ain't free. Let's just make that clear. We think we free, but we ain't.
We're not free mentally.
Exactly. Facts. That's the worst form of slavery. You know what I'm saying?
Mentally, yeah.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Because
a lot of coons out here.
Hakuna Matata.
Yeah, that's what it is. A lot of them. You
know? No, real shit. Like, I'm still kind of, I don't know how to see it, right? Like, you got people like T.I., you know, and I quote, you read that nigga's quote. He said, read his post, sorry. He said, yo, I'm ready to ride with y'all. But then as soon as they started fucking shit up in the A, yo, y'all chill, y'all calm down.
Yeah, too close to home after that.
Yeah, like, nigga, you just said you ready.
I'm proud of y'all, you know, I'm proud to see what's going on. We finally united. But then once the riots get too close, it's like, hey, or either... That contract you signed said, hey, you're going to have to go tell them you're not a part of this. Or you're going to lose money.
Yeah.
That's when you see their true intentions start coming out as well.
Yeah. You see what I'm saying? Because it's like, come on, bro. You was just there saying like, yo, you ready? You ready? Y'all ready? I'm ready.
Two-faced.
But then.
He just doing it for the show.
Yeah.
He's doing it for social media.
I feel like when I was looking at the press conference, I do feel like he is genuine somewhat. But I feel like what Shayna was saying. He got that
call.
Sign
that contract.
Yeah.
Bling, bling.
We talk about on every single podcast that contract. Once you sign over, once you become a celebrity or it's a sacrifice you got to continuously make to keep that money coming in.
He
haven't been putting out that much music. You know, he got his podcast.
He got
a big old family. Like, come on. What are you going to really do?
Yeah.
You know, right. You got that lifestyle to maintain. Yeah,
that's
you know
why I can't be the celebrity.
We gonna be celebrities, Shimmy.
This is what we're doing now. It's not day by day.
Okay, not to go off topic, but
I ain't
gonna
assassinate you, man.
No, but listen, it's just not. Despite no matter what you, whatever you do in your celebrity, or you have a big following, or you influencer, whatever you do, right? You do an endless slip up, everybody on social media knows what to do, and they put you out there.
Correct.
But some people don't gotta sell a soul. Like, look at J. Cole. Like, he was just the other day, he was in a prison.
Rapping.
Chilling, rapping for inmates.
He was at the protests too. I saw him at a couple of protests.
Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Posted him. Yeah.
It just, man.
And he do numbers.
Yeah.
But he said in his first album, like after he done his first album, he was like, "I can never do it again. I can't sell my soul for this no more.
Yeah.
So I'd rather be independent."
Yeah.
Because I'm gonna
He ain't with the Rock no more.
I don't know. But he said that in his first album.
Oh, because I was wondering why I don't ever see him at like the Rock brunch and stuff like that.
I don't know.
It's a headache. I want to be able, because I'm a type of person,
mm-hmm.
I have to do whatever I want to do. You know what I mean? I would like to put things on my schedule.
They give you that call, like, yo, you need to sacrifice your little cousin. 100 million in your account. What's up?
I don't do everything for money.
All lives are okay.
Some people will get duped in the booty just to get that contract. I'm not doing it.
Money.
I I was arguing with some friends the other day, and it was just like, oh, $1 million or $100 million. Just because.
People don't switch up over that money, correct. Yo.
It don't even that take money don't though.
You don't die with that money.
Yeah,
money
like that dude that took out Nipsey. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think they gave him what, like 60,000 or 70,000. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it'd be agents. Wow. Well, dudes, I feel like it's dudes that they know that don't got nothing to live for.
Yeah.
Just got right.
You said what?
The dude that took out Nipsey.
At his store when they shot him, all a setup.
You got paid for that. That was a
all
setup.
All these things, I mean, not all, but most some of these things be set ups.
Yeah. There's always, that's how I know not all of us are going to reach that vibration. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're always, like, if you look at history, even back with Marcus Garvey, even back with Malcolm X, there was always
someone
that they could call and put within the mist and say, yo,
to make it look factual.
Take that down.
Yeah.
They did it with Marcus Garvey. You know what I'm saying?
Malcolm
they did it
X.
with Malcolm X.
Yes.
They do it with all of them. Yes. You know what I'm saying?
It's always a sacrifice.
To get close. They put it in Belly. Did you see Belly?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
oh
yeah,
my
yeah.
God, Shayna.
That's
my ex about no more movies. Like,
oh
I thought we
goodness.
Was on.
You guys not gonna talk
we
about
we
no more Karen's movies.
Today.
Like,
are
you
we
ain't
Karen?
Seen Belly?
No. I even want
Lennox?
I even need it. However do you want me? However. Oh my God.
With DMX and Nas, Nasty Esco?
Unfortunately.
What
I
the
haven't seen
fuck?
It.
Where was you at? You in LA?
I was down here.
How you didn't see Belly, though?
What? Told you, like, I just started watching movies.
What?
I just like literally.
So we gonna get you
movies.
All the DVDs. We gonna write a list because they put everything in the movie. If you saw Belly, after DMX got out of jail, you see what I'm saying? He was on the basketball court, and an agent. Hey, we know you. You're going away for a long time. Huh. You know we need you to get next to the minister. You see what I'm saying? Mm. So he kind of got into the Nation of Islam. He was studying.
Wow.
He was reading. And he had to get close to the minister to take him out. You know what I'm saying? But while DMX was reading and learning, he started to take on some of the principles that he was reading. Like, damn, like some good shit. You know what I'm saying? Because DMX was the most toxic one in the movie. Nas was the one that was kind of more awakened. He wanted to go back to Africa with his queen. You know what I'm saying? And shit like that. So they always put stuff in the movies to let you know. And that's how they still do it now. You know what I'm saying? We just got to understand and be aware that not every black person is going to go. There are some traitors in the midst. You know what I'm saying? That's what they call Stockholm Syndrome, where you love your master. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to see him hurt. You love your master more than you love yourself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Cool.
Master would say, we sick. Like Malcolm X would say, are we sick, boss?
Yeah.
Are we sick? That's the type of mentality of the house nigga.
They coons.
Kuna Matata. Mm. Him Kuna Alata.
Yeah, that's just me though. I'm just even though it'll help my family and everything, but I just can't fuck up.
You can't just sell out.
What fuck up what's
for
going
money.
On that line, you know, just for money.
You just feel
like
your soul, like
you're gonna
feel
bad.
Yeah,
later
like
on, you're like, damn, I really fucked up.
If you got any attunement with your inner soul, with your inner spirit,
you're gonna be feeling like something just not connected.
Yeah, you're gonna feel like it ain't clicking.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Cause that's how I feel like. If something meant for you to do, you could just do it without turning back and feeling no regret with it.
Without
you
know stabbing nobody.
You know what I mean?
But I feel like there's only a certain level you can get to. Like, look at Dave Chappelle when they were trying to get him to put on a dress and they was calling him crazy because he turned down $50 million.
Mm. Yeah.
And went to Africa. They was calling him loco. Nah, he ain't want to be with
soul.
The shits.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, why I gotta put on a skirt for?
Yeah,
you know what I mean. That's why I feel
he
like.
His own thing.
Yeah,
there's one particular skit that he did. Not even skit. He said in a Netflix
series.
I never thought about that. He was just like, so the people, the producers called him to the office. He's like, hey, you know, you have to stop saying, you know, faggots and all that stuff. He was just, he said he walked out. Okay. But he said he turned around. And he was like, "So I can't say faggot or anything like that, but I can say nigga."
Exactly.
Facts.
Like,
oh yeah, you could talk down to your own people, but you can't say faggot. You know
correct.
What I'm saying? And I feel like he stayed true to his craft. That's why he's being blessed. You know what I'm saying? Like, you to the point where he was even doing comedy in the parks, not getting no money.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, he was just raw with it. So I feel like, you know, if you do stay true to yourself, the universe will bless you. You ain't gotta sell out. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gotta, you know, be a coon.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And even just like what Shimmy said, like you see how Dave Shapiro, he was able to
who?
Well, Dave Chappelle. Sorry about that.
Oh, Shapiro. Yeah. I was like, hold on, man.
Yeah, he was able to actually like pinpoint that how they could say like the N word,
yeah,
but they couldn't say, you know, the F word. Yeah, you know, I'm trying not to really say it.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we ain't got nothing against gays. You know what I'm saying? Let's make that straight. If that's the because I saw a post where somebody was saying, well, you know, LGBT life matters too. Like, this ain't about y'all right now. Go sit down. We need y'all on the front lines.
Before you get cursed, LGBTQ.
LGABCD. What?
LGBTQ.
We ain't trying to offend y'all. Yeah. This ain't about y'all right now.
They humans also.
Y'all humans. You know what I'm saying? But this ain't really about y'all right now. Don't be trying to slide in here and get no shine. You know what I'm saying? We ain't got no offense. But if some of y'all who are men still, and you got hands and you could pick up arms, now's the time to take off them nails. You know what I'm saying? And pick up that Glock. You know what I'm saying?
I
agree. If you want to shoot with your skirt on, you know, that's cool. You know what I'm saying? You know, like, whatever, bro. Whatever. But I don't want to see no, like, this is another shit. I don't want to see no black woman at no Chinese spots getting your nails done.
Yeah.
Fuck that. You know what I'm saying?
Vietnamese and Philippines.
Hell no. Find you your sister that's doing nails. You know what I'm saying? There are black nail technicians out here, because Chinese don't give a shit about us neither.
They talk shit about us. But wait. You know what I learned yesterday? Somebody told me, just like, we have to start supporting black businesses.
We
and all that stuff. They say because that dollar can stay in that community for a couple of days.
Correct.
They say with the Jewish, it can stay there for a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
I was just like, damn.
With us, we give it right to them.
Somebody else. Yeah.
There you go. Take my money.
I was just like, damn. We need to.
Yeah.
We need to go back to do our own Black Wall Street, our own strip, with like, you know.
Exactly. What? That's exactly what it, we need to do. Exactly, our own shit. We got to get back to.
I think that's why they don't respect us, because then we don't have our own shit.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Come on. Shout out to the Black Rolodex. You know what I'm saying? That's a black excellence group that I'm a part of, that's actually trying to find solutions to the problems that's going on. You know what I'm saying?
I like that.
We have to get back to that. It's like what you were saying with the Black Wall Street. We got to realize they bombed us.
Yeah.
We was doing our own thing, chilling. You know what I'm saying? And that's one of the reasons why they assassinated Martin Luther King. Because he even said in one of his quotes, I feel like I integrated my people into a burning building.
Correct.
Because before he was with all this kumbaya.
Yeah.
But then he realized, like, yo, hold up. I think I fucked up. Yeah. And then he started wanting to get that check. When we're coming for that check.
And it's so crazy. It's like, what we really can fuck them up at with their pockets.
Yeah, that's what we got to do.
Because
we're not ready for a war yet. We're not ready to
fuck up their pockets first.
Yes.
Let's get them off guard. You know what I mean?
Correct.
So that's
Stop buying this shit. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even realize Crafty Crab is owned by Chinese people.
Yeah.
They shit good too. I ain't going to front.
We can do our own stuff. Look at Louisiana. We can do our own stuff. Like,
yeah, no, you're right. But it's just the mentality of our people. Like, we're so.
So used to it and conformed already to
niggas be lined up at Crafty Crab.
Correct. Yeah.
Like around the block.
Our own stuff. Like, you know what's so crazy? I feel like we should have like every state or anywhere, we should have like a black area with like black businesses. We can have Chinese food. We can have our own black Chinese food.
No, you're right.
You know what I mean?
Correct.
We can make fried rice with our own seasoning, our own flavor and all that stuff. We can spice it up and enhance it. We can do whatever we want. You know what I mean?
No,
like
right.
My cousin, he's a chef. Like, he can make that
hibachi and all
that. And we put our own Haitian seasoning in it and good as hell. Like,
make it good. As long as we're staying into the lines of being healthy. I think that's why a lot of our minds are not seeing the bigger picture, because a lot of us
just
don't realize
the foods and stuff.
Exactly. Yeah. The foods are killing us. They done got this shit mapped out. They got all kind of ways to get us.
Yeah.
School system, food. Foods. Entertainment, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. They done found all kind of ways to get at us. But if we start just baby steps.
Making small steps.
Yeah.
You know, the waters, like drinking more water, meditating, you know, yoga.
Yeah.
You know, those little small things
more
like that, so we can
with
think
your,
better.
Your kind.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And doing more things like black on together, like starting groups. You know, even just we need protection groups as well.
I Correct.
Feel like we don't even know how to really protect ourselves against like walking out the house like these days is that deep.
Yeah, no, you're right.
It'd be kind of scary for me. Cause like
we need the Black Panthers right now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Leaving the crib, like, you know.
Not knowing if you're going to get back home. Yeah. Like, you're just driving in your car. Like you don't know.
You know what I'm saying? That's why it's hard for a black man.
It's hard for a melanin person. You know?
No, you're right.
Whatever gender they are.
Cause just because y'all leave the house, I'll be perfectly good. No beef, no gain, no nothing. But a fucking cop can just bang.
Get right behind
you. You know, the other day, like, I'm sorry. The other day, I woke up.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is the day after, like, everybody really started publishing like, the George Floyd death.
Yeah.
I was just like, yo. I was really thinking. I was shaking. I was like, damn. Like, I can leave the house.
Could be
a
you.
Cop can pull me over and, like, do any fucking thing. And he'll get away with it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That could have been any of us.
Mm-hmm. It's like, it's so crazy. Cause, like, just because I know me. Like, I have a mouth. Like, I'm just not going to let anybody do anything to me. You know what I mean? I know my rights. So it's just like, dog.
See, but that's that. See, that's that emotional
thing. That's
shit.
I know.
Man.
That's the thing.
Like, that's what's going to get us killed. Yo, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I was really thinking. I was like, fuck. Yeah. I know myself. And I had a friend tell me, like, yo, Spence, I know your mouth. You just gotta like chill, whatever.
Just relax. You gotta make it home.
Even when you stop and you know your rights, it still can escalate from 0 to 100 anyway. So even if you're not saying the wrong thing, you could just be sitting in your car. It's all depends
just
on
be chillaxing.
The good cop versus the bad cop who stops you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's why we need the Black Panthers again. Correct. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't realize that. Like, it wasn't just a movie. There was real Black Panthers. Like, they still got some of the real Black Panthers in prison right now. You know what I'm saying? And they was just a group that was set up to protect Black people against police brutality. You see what I'm saying?
Even helping the Black people themselves, feeding them,
I think food stamps started from them. You know what I'm saying? Where they was giving back food and all that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? So these are all great conversations. You know what I'm saying? These are great things that needs to be brought to our attention. You know what I mean? Especially with the gang culture. Like, y'all, fuck all that. Oh, yeah, who wearing blue,
Black,
who wearing red, and all of that shit.
All of that.
We got to come together. Organize. You want to say something, Goddess?
No, I'm just really processing it, too, because, you know, like, I told you, like, all week, they got me on that emotion tip, because, you know, all week I had to really just process it as well, because I felt like, you know, not in my conscious mind, I was ready to just go out there and express myself the way I shouldn't, but after I processed this and I seen, like, how the actual Europeans studied us and how
they
riots and how they know that certain things emotionally are going to get us riled up like this. Mm-hmm. Now I know we have to get them where it hurts at. So it does circulate with the dollar bill, the money, economics. Once we get into economics, then we can get into politics. Once we get into the politics, we can get into, you know, the court systems and things like that.
Correct.
But we can't do that until we all come collectively with the funds.
No, you're right.
That's really where we at.
With
right
the entertainers,
now.
The that's what
got
I feel
the
like.
Money
yeah, low, like I feel like Jay, you hit a Billy,
you know
Kanye, y'all are the funders of this situation because every war needs finances.
Correct.
You see what I'm saying? Like, y'all got enough bread. This is where y'all need to come together. The Jay Morrisons, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody keeps saying, we're sending money to the bailout reform, but how do you know? How do you know that money really going there?
Exactly.
Like, we haven't saw one person that said, "Hey, I got arrested and this company
bailed me out."
You know what I'm saying? But all the celebrities jumped onto that.
Yeah.
And then, you know, now that we on this topic too, it's really funny how I've been getting a lot of emails from like all of these like big on like companies. Like, I don't want, you know, I don't know if I should say names, but you know, y'all been,
call them out. Call them out.
Like Tory Burch.
Don't be a chatty pack.
You know, like the Tory Burches, like all the mainstream like companies, everybody's saying, "Oh, we support the Black Lives Matter
liars
movement." Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, why now?
Why now? Because when Kaepernick was kneeling,
everybody
was crucifying.
They
didn't get
that guy apology.
Yeah,
that was a peaceful.
The
protest.
NFL should apologize to him.
Yeah,
but now we getting all these emails, and it's like, why? Because the white crime or the Caucasian crime, you know, is what they really try to distract us from. So they use all this black on black violence, all the police brutality on blacks to distract us from the white crime that a lot of people don't even know about.
Exactly.
Yeah, so that's they do every
like,
day.
Correct.
Exactly.
So it's like, yeah, y'all companies want to jump on board because y'all need our dollar.
Plus,
they need
our,
y'all don't want
you
that investigation. You remember, y'all remember the Pizzagate stuff?
No.
Well, I'll let that go.
No. Bring it up. No. Enlighten us.
Give us a quick gist.
We know a lot about movies. You know about some other stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Tell us. What's up?
I mean, there was a lot of these like big old like companies that was getting investigated for like sex trafficking.
Mm.
A lot of them. So like all these organizations now, it's just coincidental that since that's on hold because everybody's talking about the George Floyd thing, it's like now y'all keep on wanting to get us back on y'all side for some reason. But don't use us as bait. You know what I'm saying? Because this has been happening, as you said before. Like, this has been happening. So why now? Why is all the whole world on this?
Well, exactly.
Yeah, it's just because, like, they know that we're distracted.
Because they know that we got the money.
Yeah, if they correct. Know if we they
so
have
they,
us,
so once
they don't want to automatically.
Correct. So once we do get back into after, you know, it's funny, we haven't heard about the COVID now since George Floyd.
Yeah, all that shit. At first, everybody had to stay six feet. Now everybody outside, grouping like together. Everybody, you know what I'm saying?
Like, what happened to COVID? Because it's, all of these things are a distraction. So like, once they really lift everything up, the curfews and everything, and they get these entertainers, I heard them saying, like, basketball might be back out in July. So once y'all get everything back in tune, y'all want us to start spending money
of course.
With them. So it's like, don't send the emails out, though. Like, come on.
That's why the owner of the NFL came out with that video. Like, we believe Black Lives Matter.
he's doing that, but he ain't apologized to goddamn
Kaepernick.
They didn't even do apologies for
him. Yeah, give him a personal. I mean, I respect the NFL players that did do a little video and say that, you know, Our Lives Matter. That should have been me.
They should have been behind
him. They should have been, they were scared, you know what I'm saying? But they should have been behind Kaepernick that whole time.
It was a peaceful protest that he was doing. Only thing he did was kneel through the actual anthem.
The anthem. And that's a racist anthem any damn
correct.
Way.
Correct.
And it's so crazy.
It should be your choice. Like, why do you have to stand for that?
Nah.
Because I guess it was in the contract.
We giving you $10 million. You better stand.
It's in the contract.
Yeah.
That's what all comes down to. It's so crazy.
Like, he's been doing it years before. Exactly. People just thought he was just tripping. But boom.
He bugging. Now everybody want to put their knee down and kneel. The cops want to put their...
He kneed right on the man. Joyce Ford.
Hell yeah. He kneeled in the same type of way. So that's... I mean, that don't make you... feel like saying it's fishy. You see what I'm saying? Because even the chief of police of Minneapolis, you know, when he was being interviewed, they was like, yo, this, I don't even know how to pronounce his name. What is it, Chauvin? You know, the assassinator. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Chauvin, whatever the hell his name is. He had like 18 complaints against him prior to that. Like, he killed a Hispanic person. I think his name was like Wayne Reyes or something like that. So he been doing this. So don't tell me now, oh, you know, we're here with the people. You know, I want to let the people know that we're here
horrified.
For them.
I can't believe this happened.
Yeah, nah, he been doing this shit. Y'all only doing something now because everybody got their phone out.
And everybody's talking about it.
Exactly.
Just, you know, to me, it just, the whole thing just look fishy. Like, how do you just consciously, you deliberately have your knee there and you just freely just standing
just
there.
Just chilling.
Like, oh yeah, this is what I'm doing. Like, so you didn't get up no time. Like, how does that make sense?
Exactly.
Man, come on, man. I'm pretty sure they know about CPR and all that stuff. Like, it's the neck, man. Like, really? It's fucked up, dog.
Yeah. No, you're right.
He's a grown man crying for his mother, dog.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's the shit that they do. I remember one time I was on Las Solas, you know what I mean? Getting back in my old days, you know, when I was rowdy. And I wasn't even resisting. My hand was like this.
Yeah.
That freaking cop had me in a chokehold like that down to the ground.
Correct.
My cousin, I'm like, yo, chill. Da, 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 da. So that white privilege shit and stuff like that happens for real.
Yeah.
I remember Las Solas like a couple months ago. I ain't like what this cop did. You know, like I said, my mouth's crazy. And then me and him was just going back at it. And then the people was like, black people was just like, man, it's chill, man. Don't worry about that, man. Because they're like, man, like one guy grabbed me. I don't know. He was just like, yo, don't worry about that, man. Because you know that shit. That shit can escalate, but don't worry about that. Yeah, man. Fuck that pussy ass. You know, that C word.
Fuck that pussy ass hoe, dog. You know,
nah, he ain't said that hoe. He said that C word. I ain't going to say that. Yeah, pussy ass cracker, man.
That's saltine, man.
Yeah.
Nah, but that white privilege is something that's dead ass serious. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, and a lot of them know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, even
they
in
pull
the,
that card out.
Oh, hell yeah. Yep. Like, my son's mom is dating a Caucasian. You know what I'm saying? And we was going through our little battle for my son, and I was coming out the courthouse, and all he had to do was tell the officer he has a warrant on him. Mind you, we now coming out from seeing the judge. He has a warrant. They bum rushed me like, let me see your ID. I'm like, hell no. Nah. Why? Just because he said that shit? They pulling out, let me see your ID. I ain't showing y'all shit unless y'all get his ID. You see what I'm saying? So they know for sure that white privilege is real. That's why people like Jane Elliott, you know what I mean? Like, she had a documentary called Blue Eyed, where she was in an auditorium asking a group of white people, like, how many of you in here would want the same treatment as black people? I don't think none. You heard me. No, man, stand
I'm
up.
I'm sure.
So that means you know what's going on. You see what's going on. But you don't want it for yourself. So why would you want it for them?
Correct.
You see what I'm saying? So it's like, come on. We got to be aware of that type of stuff too.
They fucked up by that. They don't want our treatment, but
yeah,
they want to take. They want to capitalize on everything
they
else.
Want
exactly.
They want everything
the way
that
we
do,
look, or the way we speak,
exactly.
On music. But
it
y'all
makes
don't
no
want
sense.
The treatment though.
It
well,
don't want
yeah.
everything else.
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
That y'all want the food. Y'all want the food. Y'all want
y'all
everything.
Y'all want the fried chicken.
Y'all want the
all
sun.
They
y'all, they
want
be
the
out
body.
There
they
getting
the,
sun tans and all of that. Y'all
yeah.
want everything it
they
takes,
want the slang.
But not
they want all
the
that.
Actual word.
Mm-hmm.
But they, just, they don't want to get treated out of it, though.
What's up, dog?
You know what's so crazy? I feel like we should have our own entertainment, our own radio stations.
Correct.
Like,
no, we should.
Own, like, you know,
well, we need like, our own platforms.
Our own media.
Yes.
Because we
yes.
can't be on
Instagram.
We can't be
on
Facebook.
These iPhones.
On these typing and
saying all of this stuff.
Saying all of what we're doing.
Listening.
They own all this shit.
Correct.
They listening. So that's why, like what you said, they're always 10 steps ahead of us.
Correct.
They always know what's going on. So we got to start putting our money together
and
because
economics.
I don't think the entertainer is going to do it.
No.
We got to start putting our money together. Stop trying to go buy Jordans mm-hmm. and all this dumb shit. You already got enough. Start pulling our money together and let us start finding
preparing.
The people that are
yes.
techs, finding the people that know how to do these things. You see what I'm saying?
And
it's
people,
lawyers, all of
phone system.
Yeah. There's people who don't do that. Dude. Like, have our own radio broadcasting different
yeah.
stations.
All
media
platforms.
You know what
yeah.
I mean?
Mm-hmm.
TV channels, like, all that stuff. Like,
yeah,
bro.
Not
yeah.
no BET. To be clear.
Well,
cool.
speaking of BET.
Yeah, that's that cool stuff.
Well, there's a black woman that's the founder. I mean, that's the owner right
cool.
now. But the founder... He came out the other day speaking about he's trying to get like $14 trillion for reparations for black people. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Trillion.
I don't know how true
I think
that's
going to
happen,
that.
But I mean, I want that check. They ain't
yeah,
give us our 40 acres in the
yeah.
mule. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
You know what I mean? They give us this little 1,200, but.
That wasn't enough.
Yeah.
How did Jews get money?
Who? The Jews?
Yeah.
How did oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, it's why I feel like the world is run by them. You know what
no,
I'm saying?
Having, like, look at the Indians. Like
Native Americans.
Yeah, they got their own tribes.
Mm-hmm.
See, Native Americans.
Yeah.
Everybody got a check but us.
It's fucked up, man. And we're the one who built this country.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? All of it. Man, I feel like we could go on forever and forever and forever and forever about this shit, man. You know, we just got to start taking shit seriously. Let's group up with the people that are ready to group up, but not a lot of us are going to be going back or wanting to go back. A lot of us still want to be stuck in the matrix. You see what I'm saying? But the ones who do want to come together, the ones who do want to be collective, we need to start forming groups and sitting down and start having these conversations.
Yes.
You correct. Know what I'm saying? I'm banging on anybody with that 1D shit. I don't want to hear no dumb rap, no, you know what I'm saying?
What's
NBA 1D? Scooter or Hooter, whatever these stupid names is, all
what?
These rappers.
What's
6ix9ine? I saw this nigga on social media, like he coming out with a remix with Akon. I'm like,
that shit,
like,
that shit looks stupid.
Like,
bro.
Really? Don't let me. Like,
get
the hell out of
here. They be the distractions,
dumb.
Man.
He
like
yeah.
A
like,
a distraction.
Come on, man. He got his hair bent.
Yo, that's looking like straight Fugo nonsense, bro.
Yeah, like, nah.
The hell
bro.
On that guy.
Distractions,
yeah.
distractions.
Sorry. We ain't going for that, though.
Correct. Let's
yeah,
not
yeah,
fall
we ain't
for
going for that, dude.
That's what they want us to
do. What you gotta do.
Yeah.
On that stuff.
Oh,
know?
Yeah.
It's part of his contract to say these type of things to get these reactions. That's what I'm saying. Like, mm-hmm. they know the agents, they way ahead of us. So they use certain people to rile us up, as I told y'all earlier.
No,
like,
you're right.
We
yeah,
gotta,
to get in
gotta,
our emotions.
Yes.
I think it's called a PSYOP or something.
We
got to like
change
that.
Our mindsets.
Yeah.
Yeah,
mindset. You
yes.
know what I'm saying?
We need to protect the black woman.
Oh, yeah. Protect the black woman. Protect
yes.
the goddess.
Uplift them, you know.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
We
yeah.
love you black men as well.
Yeah.
Black
thank
kings.
You.
You know,
you love us.
We're coming yeah. together. You know, it's no
cool
more just daughter. Black woman's not protected.
Having
the black man's not protected
sex.
As well. Have spiritual sex?
Yeah.
Listen.
We got to sign off
that's,
on that note. We got to sign off on this
that's
note.
A good thing because, you know, raw sex was just spiritual connection. You're building that bond together. So.
Listen.
You know
make sure y'all click the link below. Subscribe. Italkgrey. Make sure y'all get y'all Henuware, www.henu.com. Make sure y'all go follow the page. Click that button below. You know what I'm saying?
Post
we out of here.
Blessings.
Follow my dog, DJ Shibby.
At Shimmy the Prince.
God is Shayna.
Thank you, guys.
You know what I'm saying? We out of here, man. Italkgrey.
Peace.
Yo.